After months of testy and tense negotiations, a Brexit deal is done. The UK and EU finally reaching a trade agreement. It means economic chaos and major disruptions should be averted when Britain breaks free on January 1.
Boris Johnson with two thumbs up and finally a Brexit trade deal. 4.5 years since the UK voted to leave the EU.
We have completed the biggest trade deal yet, worth £660 billion a year.
After 1,646 days of legal, political and diplomatic wrangling, the agreement comes 1 week shy of the end of the Brexit transition period. Both sides triumphant, declaring it a good deal.
It is fair, it is a balanced deal, and it is the right and responsible thing to do for both sides.
While the details of the deal are yet to be released publicly, it covers all manner of subjects, from tariff-free trade to police cooperation across borders. The UK reclaims its fishing waters and cuts ties with the European Court of Justice.
We've taken back control of our laws and our destiny. We've taken back control of every jot and tittle of our regulation in a way that is complete and unfettered.
The Brexit debacle has seen the downfall of two prime ministers.
I'm about to go to Buckingham Palace to tender my resignation to Her Majesty the Queen.
And uproar on UK streets.
Stop the coup! Stop the coup!
Today, the sentiment most expressed, relief, tinged with resignation.
A deal is obviously better than no deal.
It's good to have a deal. It's not clear to me yet that the deal is any better than what we had in the first place.
It's taken them 4.5 years to get there. And how many prime ministers have we gone through to get to it?
The UK Parliament will now be recalled on December 30, just 1 day before the deadline, so that MPs can consider and then vote on the deal. It also has to be ratified by the European Parliament.
When this deal comes before Parliament, Labour will accept it and vote for it.
But there is a warning. Come December 31, exporters face a host of new border checks, which means more paperwork and likely more delays for these truck drivers still stuck at the Port of Dover. In London, Kari-Anne Greenbank, Nine News.